Welcome to the Gundog app. We are going to help you today learn how to use the app more effectively, make it easier during your training programs to have the app in your pocket every day. Lots of people are asking us, what's the best way to use it, Ben? There's so many videos. You've given us so much content on here. There's over 300 videos. Sometimes I'm not quite sure where to start. I'm going to tell you how I use it and how I teach my clients to use it. So I like to have a daily training program every day, something to focus on each day, rather than look at the app and go, there's hundreds of videos, where do I start today? It's Monday. I like to say, right, okay, I'm gonna work on something today. I'm gonna work on recall and steadiness. So I would go to the video on recall and steadiness. I then bookmark that video. I then put that into my training. And I then go to my training on a daily basis. And I know I've got that video within that section on my training. So I would try and have four or five videos I'm working on with an individual dog. Or if I've got multiple dogs, I'd have multiple things saved. So I'd know that I'd have to work on this two or three videos this week. And if I can master those videos, then I know that I can then unbookmark them and put some more into my training program. And then I can download them as well, which I think is a really good idea, because when I'm out and about, I haven't got any Wi-Fi. If you're in the woods, wherever you are, in a remote location, I've got them on download. I've got them there when I need them. And quite often my clients and even myself will come in the morning. I've let the dogs out for a wee in the toilet. I've fed them, sorted them out, put them back in the kennels, and then come back in the house. Or if they're in the house, you'll come back in the house for breakfast. During breakfast, I quite often then say, right, I've got a training session at, say, 9, 10 o'clock this morning. I'll then look at the videos, watch them through myself. Right, these are the two videos I need to really focus on today with my young dog. I'll then watch them through once or twice, get it right in my mindset in the correct way, how I'm going to do it, how I'm going to approach it, what ground I'm going to use, where I'm going to use it, what dummies I'm going to use. Then I'll go out and get the dog, and I'll start implementing the BG Foundation training programs. If I find that it's not working, I just pause the training, put the dog on the lead, and watch the video again, and then practice again. So I'm basically there with you 24/7 when you need me to help you with each training program. And then people say to me, well, I've got an older dog, Ben. How do I train this older dog? It's got issues, it's problems, it's chasing, it's pulling me. It's very simple. You go back to the basic stage and you reboot the dog system again and you start to reteach the dog. When I have a dog in for residential training, if it quarters really well, but it pulls, or it doesn't stop on the whistle that well, and they're in for a month or two, then I'll make sure I go back to the basics and I'll reteach those foundation commands correctly. And I'm happy that the dog is doing those commands, then I'll slowly then progress onto more advanced stuff. But I need to be happy that the dog can do those basics in the right way, and the way that we expect them to do it, in the positive way, in a fun way, but in a way that I know is going to work when I advance through the other training programs. And it really helps me, even though the app is my training methods, it's things I've designed. There's so many videos and so many techniques. I need to remind myself of what I'm doing each day. So I have this set in my program. I go out, I focus on those things. Once I've mastered them, then I progress to the next stage. And it's so lovely and satisfying when I've sit down on an evening after training my dog and I go, right, I can now unbookmark those four training programs. They're done, they're finished. I can revisit them every so often to make sure they're still working, but I've mastered them, dog can do it, the dog fully understands what's required, enjoys it, wants to do it, they're unbookmarked. I then go and put three or four more things in, and to feel that advancement each time and add in those new videos is really exciting for me. And I know that a lot of the BG community say this to me, that it's lovely that they know they've sort of parked the basics and they're moving on and progressing really well. And some people are on, you know, 15-month, two-year-old stuff now, and they're starting to do directions on game and directions over fences, over lakes, and they're really progressing, but it's taken them a year of the app, and each week and each month, they're progressing each time and unbookmarking and adding new things into my training. And like I've said this all along, it's 80 pence a day. For me, it's a complete no-brainer. I designed it to help you all train your dogs. And while I am seeing, and I'm hearing from other professional trainers, that clients have the app, is that you're coming to us for lessons And there's a month normally in between a lesson. Most people can afford to come for a one-to-one once a month. And that period in between that month's training, they're going away working on the app. They're turning up at trainers and at mine, and I'm going, wow, your dog's doing everything. It's sitting, it's staying. All we can do is we can polish it, we can advance it, we can move on so much quicker now. I've not had any negativity from trainers saying to me, Ben, they're coming to me when they're using different methods than me. It doesn't work. Well, my methods work. Trainers know it works. It's worked at the highest level in the world that they're in. So it does work. So they're happy that they might want to add their commands, add a few of their techniques. Of course, that's their training methods. That's fine. But the fundamental basics of sit, leave, recall, stopping, left and right, forwards, backwards, all those things are set in stone to enable those trainers to firstly help their clients and enjoy their lessons so much more. And I'm finding my lessons are so much more rewarding for me as a trainer, so much more rewarding for my clients. We're getting on, we're enjoying ourselves, making it really an enjoyable experience when they come to me for a lesson, rather than, you haven't been working hard enough during this month. Well, Ben, you told me so much in my last lesson. I forgot half of it. I found it really hard. I went home and suck on two or three things, but I wasn't quite sure what you meant. I knew I wasn't going to see you for a month. I've cracked on and tried to do my best, but I've done it wrong, haven't I? Yes, you have. So then we've got to revisit and go back, and it makes the session a good session, but it makes the session, we're digressing, we're going back, and I want to go forward every single session. And with the app, I'm enabling people to go forward and progress every single time they invest in a lesson with me or a trainer. So good luck using the app. Join the webinars, get subscribed, and get training, and enjoy your dogs.